Then we have Shangong. That's their name was Shangong. Shangong has two implements. One is a double-sided axe, which of course is used for fighting. The other one is a rattle, which is like a maraca. And when Shangong dances, he's fighting with those implements. And the mythology says that those were the axe and the shaker were Shango's warrior buddies. And he took those and made those part of his own body. So one hand is cutting and the other hand is punching. One hand represents lightning and the other one represents thunder. That's the symbolism behind those two instruments. So Shango are known as leaders. Shangos are politicians. They're the ones who aren't afraid to be the life of the party. You don't find Shangos at a shop. It's very rare. It's very rare. It's like, basically I'm talking about what an astrology sign is. Shango colors are red and white. And if you think about a carrier in the diaspora, Muhammad Ali was a Shango. Definitely. And when he put his boxing shoes on, his trunks, he used the colors red and white. If you look at any old films of him, he used red and white. And Shangos are known for their mouths. They're not shy people. But there's also a negative side and a positive side to the Orisha. But in this relation to what I'm talking about, capoeira, Shango is your ability to lead and aggressively control the game. That's Shango. It's taking the step forward and being aggressive and controlling the game. And then we have Oya. Oh, who is it? Who's the Oya? Where's she at?
Oya.
Okay. Yeah. Same thing. Yeah. You said Yansa. Same thing. Iya means mother, Ansa is nine, mother of nine. Oya. Oya is, they say, the female counterpart of Shango. It said that Oya is represented by a tornado. So we say that when you're being complacent in your life and you're not doing the things you're supposed to do, Oya comes in and blows the wind and shakes your life up. Oya also represents unexpected change. Oya's scripture represents not to be afraid, not to run away from things. So if you're having issues with Oya, it means that you have a fear and you're running away from things. That's Oya's energy. Oya's a warrior. She's a female. Orisha on the male side, but she's a strong warrior. So it says Oya is your ability to adapt to sudden and unexpected change. So things are always changing in capoeira. Things change. Oya gives you the ability to change and adapt to that. And then we have Oshun. Who is the Oshun? Oh, yeah, you were the Oshun. Yeah. Oshun represents the beauty of the game. Does it make sense? All the prettiness is in capoeira. I like to say, if there was a mirror in front of an Oshun, they would find it. The Oshun will find the mirror. So Oshun is your ability to refine and beautify your game. Oshun is the technical perfection of the game. So when you think of the beauty of capoeira and really training, getting your technique really nice, that's Oshun's energy. And then we have Yemoja. Most people that have been to Brazil know about Yemoja, right? Yemaya, Yemoja. Yemoja in Africa is the river, but in the diaspora, she's represented by the ocean. Traditionally, we say Yemoja is big breast. So sometimes you'll see pictures of Yemoja with heavy, heavy breasts that touch the ground. In the West, that's a negative thing. It's a little aggressive, flappy, sad. In Africa, that's the thing. Because we're saying that she's a nurturer. She has enough to feed everybody. So it's a different concept. It's a whole different concept. So Yemoja is the nurturer. So Yemoja is your ability to nurture and develop your game. To really understand your game and to take time with it. It's a practice. That's Yemoja's ashe, so to speak. Obatala. In Brazil, usually called Oxalá. Obatalá is symbolized by an old man who's full of wisdom and knowledge, sometimes an old woman, but a lot of wisdom and knowledge, and moves very slow, but can always pick you apart. So Obatala is that person that plays a nice slow game like Angola, but you got somebody doing fast and hitting up, and boom, the Angolero kicks. And they're trying to figure out how they got in because they think they're faster than them. It's like a Shango who doesn't understand his energy, and he goes fast and then Obatala slows him down. But Shango's colors are, Shango's colors are red and white. The red and white means that if there's too much fire, you can burn yourself out. The white within Shango is to mellow them out, to bring that energy down, peaceful energy. So that's Obatala's energy. So Obatala is the wisdom, the maturity, the ethics of the game. The ethics of the game, very important, the ethics of the game. Obatala is big, all the Orishas are big on ethics and morality, but Obatala, that's his domain. And coolness in the heat of battle. Obatala is always cool and calm. Always cool and calm. Obatala's colors are white. Oshala's colors are white. Obatala is also responsible for creativity. So it's your creative aspect of the game, of Capoeira. And then last, I have Egun. And Egun are the ancestors. And this is what this day was all about, Zumbi. And Egun is the collective spirit of those that come before you, the creators, custodians, the teachers, and the innovators. So that's the ancestral aspect of Capoeira. And no matter what, you always got to look back to the ancestors who did this martial art before you. You have to pay homage to them. And you don't have to be, again, you don't have to be a practitioner of Candomblé or Ifa, but it's still giving homage. And this is, it's nice that you decided to do this. You know, because everyone has an ancestor, and you have to respect the ancestors and the base of where the art comes from. I was talking on the radio last night about the mixed martial arts, and I always go on record saying that I respect what they do. They're excellent fighters. I like that. I do some of that in my martial arts studio. But there's a danger within the mixed martial art community because they have no loyalty to anyone. Their loyalty is to the knockout. That's it. Is that correct? He's doing it. But it's very important that you pay respect. A couple of years ago, there were two American Japanese judo players. They were going, I think it was the 1988 Olympics that they were going to be going to. And they wanted to go to the Olympic Committee with a petition. They wanted to get people to sign a petition to take out the bowing in judo. They said, we're Americans, we're not bowing. That's so disrespectful. So disrespectful. The Japanese community should never, my opinion, never allow that to happen. Never, ever, ever. If you're gonna do judo, you respect the Japanese people. If you're gonna do capoeira, you respect this African-Brazilian roots. Capoeira, Brazil's developed its own thing, you know? But still, its African influence is there. There's no way you can get around it, you know? And so, it's dangerous because the mixed martial arts community has taken all the respect out. And that's not to say that people that are in mixed martial arts are a bunch of bad guys and thugs. There's good people. But that type of framework, it's dangerous because people will move in there and they won't have any respect for anything. They just won't. The whole thing they want to do is beat people up. And so with Capoeira, there's always some type of respect. If you sit down at the bean bow and you're disrespectful, you might get hit in the head with that bean bow. You know, I've seen it happen. So it's very important that you always have respect for something. You can still be a good fighter and still respect the culture and the art. And that's, like I said, that's a big concern of mine. Because, you want to take Q&A?